Welcome to this next video on measure theory. In the last video, what we have seen, we have seen the pointwise and uniform convergence. In the current video, we'll see that why the uniform convergence is better than pointwise convergence. So we'll look at some of the drawbacks of pointwise convergence. The first drawback of pointwise convergence is that if you have a sequence of continuous functions, say fn is a sequence of continuous function, and it pointwise converges to f, then it is not necessary that f is a continuous function. It means that in the pointwise convergence, the continuity property, which is an important property as far as mathematics is concerned, is not preserved while the sequence converges pointwise. So we can look at a counter example. We just look at the functions f of x, fn x is equal to x raised to power n, and you consider the interval minus 1 to 1. Now you can see that this function, this sequence of function, when n tends to infinity, you are taking you are basically taking the number which is less than 1, except at the point 1 raised to power infinity, so you'll get 0. So this function, the sequence of function, converges to 0 everywhere except at 1. So what is the limit of this function? The limit of this function is pointwise convergence limit of this function is 0 when your x is from minus 1 to 1, because from minus 1 to 1 you are having a number which is less than 1 with modulus less than 1, and n tend to infinity means you are taking the power of that number infinity, which is a less than 1 number, so you'll get a 0. And at x is equal to 1, you can say that 1 raised to power anything is 1, so at x is equal to 1, this function fn is converging to 1. So the limiting function of the sequence of functions is this function. Now you can see that x raised to power n is a continuous function because it is a polynomial function for all the values of n. So every function fn is a continuous function. And now look at the pointwise limit. This function is not a continuous function at x is equal to 1. Okay, so we have that the limit of the pointwise limit of continuous functions may not be a continuous function. So the important property of mathematics, that is continuity, is not preserved while we are dealing with pointwise convergence. Okay, so obviously if the continuity is not preserved, so differentiability is also not preserved, because if continuity is not preserved, it means that sequence of the same example, you can see that each xn, this is a differentiable function, right? But the limit, which is 0, 1, not even continuous, so it is not differentiable. So the same above example works for the fact that the pointwise limit of a sequence of differentiable functions may not be a differentiable function. Okay, so this was the first drawback, and that continuity is not preserved, and then second is differentiability is not preserved, and the third drawback is that pointwise limit of integrable functions need not to be integrable. Okay, so this is already discussed in video number 24 of major theory. You can go back and see that video in detail. Here I'll just give you the shortcut, the brief of that video. So you consider qn to be the numbers, the rational numbers in the interval 0, 1, right? So what you are collecting the rational numbers in the interval 0, 1, and you are calling those numbers as q1, q2, q3. Rationals being countable, you can actually count them, right? Okay, then you define a function fnx which is 1 when x is equal to q1, q2 up to qn, and 0 otherwise. Okay, and we have seen in that video that this function actually converges to the function 1 when x is a rational number and 0 otherwise. The pointwise limit of this function is this, which is called a Dirichlet function. Now you can see that each of this function is Riemann integrable. Again, this thing is proved in that video, but the limiting function is not Riemann integrable, right? So we have another drawback, that pointwise limit of integrable functions may not be an integrable function. Okay, the last drawback is, there are many more, but which we need, is that you cannot interchange the limit and the integral sign. Okay, for that, just look at this counter example. You define fn x for n greater than or equal to 2 as follows. You have fn x is equal to n square x, this line. Okay, when your x is between 0 to 1 by n, and then you have this 2n minus n square x when x is from 1 by n to 2 by n, and 0 when your x is from 2 by n to 1. Okay, so you have a function like this. It takes the value n square n, then 2n minus n square n, and then 0. The function is defined on the interval 0 to 1. This is called tent function. Now you can see that what is the pointwise limit of this function? When n tends to infinity, you can see that when n tends to infinity, your x is from 0 to 0, and then this x is from 0 to 0, and this x is from 0 to 1. So it means that in the whole domain, your function is converging to 0 function. Okay, so pointwise limit of this function is a 0 function. Pointwise limit is a 0 function, right? Now compute the integral of this fnx. Okay, so you can actually compute the integral of fnx. It's very simple. You just break your domain 0 to 1 into 0 to 1 by n, then 1 by n to 2 by n, and then 2 by n to 1. And you compute the integral, you will see that you are getting a 1. Okay, so it means that for each n, fnx dx is 1. The integral of each of the function in the sequence is 1. Now, so what will be the limit n tending to infinity of the integral? It will be limit n tending to infinity, and integral is 1, so 1, that is 1, right? Now, take the otherwise. If you interchange the limit and integral sign, you will get this. Integral 0 to 1, limit fnx dx. Now, what is limit fnx dx? The function sequence is converging to 0. This is pointwise limit I am talking about. So this is integral of 0 function, which is 0. So you can say that you can see that you cannot interchange this integral and limit. Okay. So these are some of the properties which are not preserved when you take the pointwise limit. But we would like to preserve these properties. Okay, at least some of these properties we would like to preserve. So that is why we are not very happy with pointwise convergence. But still we study the pointwise convergence. So what is the point of studying pointwise convergence? Okay, so the point of studying pointwise convergence is that we'll see that if a sequence fn converges uniformly to f, okay, if a sequence fn converges pointwise to a function f, and by chance if converges uniformly also, then the limit will be same. So basically pointwise convergence we study so that we get a limit f, and then we check whether the sequence of functions converge to that same f uniformly. Because if at all the convergence is uniform, then the limit in both the uniform and the pointwise convergence will be the same. Okay, so it is not that studying the pointwise convergence is useless. We get the limit when we study the pointwise convergence, and then the same limit we'll check for the uniform convergence. Now we would like to see, okay, if we have a uniform a sequence converging uniformly to a function f, what are the properties which are preserved? I'm not going to prove these properties, but I'll just let you know that whenever you have a sequence of functions which are continuous and it converges uniformly to a function f, then f is also continuous. It means that continuity is preserved in uniform convergence. And also you can suppose your fn is a sequence of Riemann integrable functions, okay, which converges uniformly to f, then you can actually interchange the limit and the integral sign. You can actually write it as integral a to b limit n tending to infinity fnx dx, which is equal to this. Okay, so you can change the limit and the integration sign. Okay, and obviously it means that if you are changing the, it means that if you are defining this thing, it means that Riemann integral of f of x is defined, right? So it means that the uniform convergence of sequence of Riemann integrable functions is again a Riemann integrable function. So all the three properties which we have seen above, not preserved under the pointwise convergence, they are being preserved, right? But differentiability is not preserved in uniform convergence, right? Because uniform convergence is not the perfect one. Nothing is perfect in this world, so uniform convergence is also not perfect. So you can see that differentiability is not preserved. We can have this example. Suppose you have a function fnx sin nx upon n is a natural number starting from 1. So this function is a differentiable function. You know that trigonometric functions are differentiable functions, and also the sequence converges to 0 uniformly. The sequence of functions converges to 0 uniformly. Now what is the derivative of fnx? So derivative of fnx is n cos of nx upon n. This is cos of nx, right? This function cannot converge pointwise to any function, right? So it means that you don't have something like this. If fnx converges to f, then derivative of fn dash converges to f dash, right? here what is happening, here we have uniform convergence, we have a sequence which is uniformly converging to zero, right, but the derivative of that sequence is not converging to the derivative of the converging function. So this is a property which is not preserved under uniform continuity, right? So this is in this video we have seen that how uniform convergence is a bit better than pointwise convergence. Thank you.